Very good afternoon to our respected Vice Principal, sir, who always inspire and motivate us. Our guest, Ms. Suchandra Gupta, HOD ma'am, our academic coordinator, our all dear faculties, and my lovely students. It is a glorious moment to extend my warm wishes on behalf of the College of Paramedical Sciences, MLT department. I want to convey my heartfelt gratitude to Ms. Suchandra Gupta for accepting the invitation and presiding over the seminar on topic opportunistic fungal infection and current scenario of mucormycosis in India. The seminar schedule brushes upon the topic, how this black fungus disease is caused, what are the signs and symptoms, how it can be cured, and what is the treatment. As we daily see and hear on TV channel about this black fungus, how many patients are dying daily and how it's causing disaster in this present day. It tends to occur most often you have weakened immunity from an illness or health condition like corona nowadays. It affects the respiratory system, lungs, eyes, etc. We will know more detail from Ms. Suchandra Gupta, microbiologist, lecturer at Faculty of Medical Health Sciences and Allied Health Sciences, SGT University, Gurugram. We welcome you, ma'am. And before the session start, I will hand over our mic to Mrs. Ruchi Kant, ma'am, our HOD, for welcoming, ma'am. Over to Ruchi, ma'am.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you so much for the nice introduction of ma'am too. Now, first of all, a very good evening to honorable guests, team members, and my dear students. Myself, Dr. Ruchi Kant, HOD, MLT department from Tirthankar Mahavir University, takes this as a glorious moment to extend my warm wishes to everyone present in the interest of today's webinar hosted by Department of MLT, College of Paramedical Sciences, Tirthankar Mahavir University. I might likewise want to offer my thanks to our regarded guest speaker, Ms. Suchandra Gupta ma'am, who have acknowledged our encouragement towards this current scenario. Now, ma'am's achievements and about the topic which ma'am is going to deliver today. So a very nice and brief introduction about Suchandra ma'am and about her high achievements. She is in charge of Hajna ma'am. Now, your participation is most important throughout the session. Right now, I have everyone on mute to avoid background noises that may distract you from listening to the webinar. At the last, without any further delay, already we have some of the time, due to some technical issues, already we have wasted some of the time. I just don't want to waste much of the time because we are eagerly waiting for the ma'am to speak. I would like to thank and request all the participants here to make the session worthwhile. So I ensure the webinar will be profitable and the next hour will be really fruitful to each of us. Please listen carefully and now not wasting much of the time. The time is turned over to Suchandra ma'am. Thank you so much. Now, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much. I would like to thank Vice Principal, sir, Dr. Ruchi ma'am, and the academic coordinators of Tirthankar Mahavir University for inviting me and for giving me the chance to be the part of this webinar. I always enjoy being among the students and share my views, share the experiences which we actually observe on a day-to-day basis. So today I'll be discussing about what are opportunistic infections and what are mucormycosis, what are the symptoms and why we should not panic until unless we are really at the risk factors. So I'm sharing my screen. Is it visible to, can anyone please answer me? Is it visible? My screen is visible?
Yes, ma'am. Your screen is visible. Start now.
All right. Thank you. Thank you so much. So my topic is opportunistic fungal infections and the current scenario of mucormycosis in India. So in my objectives, mainly I'll be covering about what is the definition of opportunistic fungal infections, what are the types of fungal infections? Mainly, I'll talk about opportunistic fungal infections. What are the predisposing factors which are actually responsible to cause this opportunistic infections? And what are mucormycosis? This is the main attraction of this webinar, I guess. And the recent scenario of mucormycosis in India and the preventive measures. So as we all know, opportunistic fungal infections, what they get. Opportunistic fungal infections, wo diseases hoti hai, jo humein generally infections nahi cause karte. Wo infections humein tab cause karte hai, when we are having some underlying factors. That is, when we are immunocompromised. When I'm talking about this word immunocompromised, it means we are having such diseases or we are at such conditions jiske wajah se humari immune system jo hai wo compromised hai ya phir wo down. I have mentioned in this, that is, some of the immunocompromised status are like that, AIDS or azotemia, diabetes mellitus, lymphoma, leukemia, and other hematological cancers, even burns. Therapy with corticosteroids, which is the major concerning reason why we are having this mucormycosis, immunosuppressants, or metabolites. So basically the problem we are having is, suddenly we are seeing that after COVID, people are getting this mucormycosis infections. Jisko media mein pehle bola, infection happened to India or what has happened to the entire world, why people are getting the infection, that we need to understand. So before that, we also need to understand what actually are what are the types of opportunistic infections. So there are candidiasis, aspergillosis, entomothelioidomycosis, penicillosis, and of course mucormycosis. Typical symptoms of penicillosis. This is how it looks. It can cause the infection. Ye jo hai inside the mouth hai, and this is jaise aap dekh rahe hain lips ke corner pe hai, and similarly these are the lesions over the face. Now comes to the main attraction of the topic. I'm sure you all must be waiting to listen more about mucormycosis than any other things, because today we are learning and we are hearing the news more about mucormycosis. So mucormycosis ko hum zygomycosis bhi bolte hain, phycomycosis bhi bolte hain. This is how the mucormycosis, jo mucus hote hain ya phir jo rhinopus hote hain, this is how it looks. Ye jo mucormycosis term bola ja raha hai, iske under mein teen major causative agents hote hain. It could be rhizobus, it could be mucor, it could be absidia. So, हमारे पास जितने samples microbiology lab में आते हैं, जितने patients के swabs आ रहे हैं, जितने हमारे पास sputum आ रहे हैं, अगर किसी को lung infection हुआ है, lung infection आज के date पे बहुत ज्यादा कम जा रहा है, आज के date पे जो infection हो रहे हैं, वो generally लोगों को ocular effect कर रहे हैं, और अगर हमारे पास किसी का tissue biopsy आता है, even after surgery अगर हमारे पास sample आते हैं, तो हम उसको अपने lab में stain से देखते हैं, that is either LPCD या फिर हम उसको 10% KOH में देखते हैं. So this is how it actually appears. किस चीज को अगर हमें दिखते हैं उस सैंपल में, तो हम उस सैंपल को पॉजिटिव रिपोर्ट देते हैं, एंड देन दैट इज द डायरेक्ट एग्जामिनेशन मेथड जिसके थ्रू हम इसको देखते हैं, एंड अगेन वी प्रोसीड फॉर द कंफर्मेटरी टेस्ट जिसके लिए हम कल्चर मेथड भी लगाते हैं. So this is how it looks. You can see it has got a typical structure of broad aseptic hyphae. जैसे आप रिबन्स लाइक इसके हाइपी को बोला जाता है, एंड इट इज ब्रॉड और इसमें कोई सेप्टेशंस नहीं है, इट इज एसेप्टेड हाइफी, एंड दीस आर द टाइप ऑफ योर स्पोर्स व्हिच आर प्रेजेंट इन द स्पोरेंजियम. दिस पार्ट इज नोन एज द कॉल्यूमेला. सो दीस ऑल स्ट्रक्चर्स हैज टू बी प्रेजेंट, देन ओनली यू कैन से इट एज अ म्यूकर, कि म्यूकर हैज बीन रिपोर्टेड फ्रॉम द सैंपल व्हिच वी हैव रिसीव्ड. सो इट इज अ सैप्रोफाइटिक मोल्ड. इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट कि ये अचानक से ग्रो कर रहा है, ये हमारे एनवायरमेंट नॉर्मली प्रेजेंट होते हैं. इट कैन ग्रो इन एनी डिकेइंग ऑर्गेनिक मैटर पे, किसी भी जगह पे ये नॉर्मली जहां भी मॉइस्ट एनवायरनमेंट होते हैं, इट कैन प्रेजेंट वेरी इजीली. पेशेंट कैन मैनिफेस्ट विद राइनोसेरिब्रल ज़िगोमाइकोसिस, व्हिच इज एक्चुअली द बेसिक प्रॉब्लम नाउअडेज जो हम लोग देख रहे हैं, दैट इज राइनोसेरिब्रल म्यूकरमाइकोसिस. इट इज अफेक्टिंग थ्रू आवर आईज एंड देन इट इज अफेक्टिंग द एंटायर साइनसेस व्हिच लीड्स टू एक्चुअली द सर्जरी, क्योंकि अगर हम उसको सर्जरी नहीं करेंगे तो हमारे ये इन्फेक्शन और भी ज्यादा करेगा और ये हमारे बोन को डिस्ट्रॉय या नेक्रोसिस करेगा. So the types of zygomycosis. हम मीडिया से जो देख रहे थे पहले हमें जो पता चला था जैसे एक ब्लैक फंगस के नाम से बोला जा रहा था उसके बाद बीच में आया था येलो फंगस भी आ गया फिर व्हाइट फंगस भी आ गया सो वी ऑल आर इन द मेडिकल प्रोफेशन एंड वी शुड नो द लिटरल टर्म द लिटरल टाइप ऑफ डिजीजेस ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर फंजाई राइट सो जैसे हम ये म्यूकोरमाइकोसिस को देखते हैं जिसके लिए आजकल हम जो रिपोर्ट्स में देख रहे हैं बाकी जगह देख रहे हैं इट इज एक्चुअली अफेक्टिंग द आई दिस यू कैन सी But it is not like that ki yes if eye infections karte hai. Apart from that, it can also cause pulmonary zygomycosis where it can infect your lungs. It can cause cutaneous zygomycosis where it can infect your skin and it can infect your skin very badly. It can cause gastrointestinal zygomycosis. It can cause isolated renal zygomycosis where it can affect the kidneys. And it can cause disseminated zygomycosis. So this is the picture which I have taken from the news clipping. This is how it actually looks. And अगर skin में manifestations होते हैं तो इस तरह से ये infections होते हैं आज के डेट में हम जो infections देख रहे हैं हम इसको देख रहे हैं eyes पे बहुत ज्यादा commonly हो रहा है So this is what I have mentioned in the rhinocerebral zygomycosis it is associated mainly with diabetes mellitus, leukemia or lymphomas. It causes extensive cellulitis that is inflammation of the cell and that tissue destruction that is it can lead to necrosis and for this particular reason isme doctor itna chance nahi leta wo usko surgery kar lete agar that is it is not curable with the drug which doctors are offering that is amphotericin B now how does it spreads it spreads from nasal mucosa from this side how it is spreading through inhalation of the spores to the turbinate bones is present here then the paranasal sinuses to the orbits the eyes it is affecting and the part with the extension to the brain there massive invasion of the blood vessels which causes major infarction the basic symptoms it includes facial pain that is basically we can have the pain in the jaw area this is the facial pain we can have headache lethargy feeling of not doing anything is lethargy In advanced cases, we can see loss of vision. See, loss of vision is not the initial step. किसी को ऐसा नहीं होगा कि आज म्यूकोरमाइकोसिस हो आज उसका loss of vision. उसको धीरे धीरे ये symptoms gradually हमें पता चलेगा और उसी time पे अगर हम doctors को नहीं दिखाते तो उस time पे problem it can perceive and then it can cause a major loss. Physical examination, it may reveal brownish blood stained nasal discharge on the affected side. Black eschar on the palate, जो हमारे palate होंगे वहाँ पे black eschar, black spots मिलेंगे. Fixed and dilated pupil. That is, जो हमारे pupil जोंगे, it would be fixed and dilated. Globulopsis and ptosis. Is the reason that is इसमें हमारा क्या होते हैं कि हमारे eyelids की dropping start होते हैं. So that is your ptosis. There is an excessive and rapid destruction of the surrounding tissue. That is why it is more infectious and it is more reason to worry about. ये करता क्या है? Surrounding जितने tissues होते हैं, उसको वो literally destroy करना start करते हैं. And spread may also occur to lungs, gastrointestinal tract, skin, occasionally to other organs. Symptoms of orbital zygomycosis. This is orbital. So, जैसे मैंने बोला, zygomycosis के बहुत सारे तरीके होते हैं. But in our lecture today, I'll be focusing mainly about this the eye infection, the rhinocerebral part. So, we also should know what are the typical symptoms of orbital zygomycosis. It can cause periorbital cellulitis. It can cause ophthalmoplegia, proptosis. That is the protrusion of eyeballs. So, our eyeballs होते हैं उसका protrude हो जाते हैं. बाहर की ओर आना start होता है. Ptosis. That is the dropping of our upper eyelid. That is ptosis. Abrupt visual loss is there. Orbital pain. The entire orbital bone may we can experience the pain. We can have facial hypoesthesia. That is, we can have problem in our facial muscles in the nerve supply. We can have problem. We can have in chewing. We can experience pain in this area in the mandible region. It may spread from orbit brain and then leading to the frontal lobe necrosis and abscess formation. So this is the type of infections that is जब हमारी skin पे infection करते हैं. I hope you all can see that. Nowadays, it is mainly common in the eyes, but if we get the infection, the inoculation is through the skin mode. It can cause this type of infections. Now, what is the laboratory diagnosis of mucormycosis? I'm sure MLT students must be very aware or बहुत लोग तो perform भी कर रहे होंगे जितने भी आपके laboratory में आते होंगे samples. तो हमारे पास सैंपल्स जो आते हैं, हमारे लैब में जितने सैंपल्स हैं, हमारे हॉस्पिटल में सिटी में जितने सैंपल्स हैं, व्हिच आई एम आई हैव ऑब्जर्व्ड फ्रॉम लास्ट यू नो 20 डेज आई हैव ऑब्जर्व्ड दैट इट इज अराउंड मोस्टली द स्वैब्स वी आर गेटिंग इवन द स्वैब्स मेनली वी आर गेटिंग ऑल द टिश्यू बायोप्सीज व्हिच वी आर गेटिंग टिश्यू बायोप्सीज के नंबर इज वेरी वेरी लेस एज कंपेयर टू द स्वैब्स And you would be very surprised to know that ki agar hamare lab mein itne samples agar hamare paas you say a day if we receive 10 samples 10 mein se almost we are giving 6 samples are having leukomycosis symptoms so we are actually reporting that so samples are like swabs ho sakte it could be sputum in that case jisme isme lung infections agar hota hai to while is the sample that is bronchoalveolar lavage fluid from respiratory system and tissue biopsies So these all are the samples which we are receiving in our microbiology lab. If the patient is having any symptoms, if the patient is having any problem, then in our microbiology lab, we perform the direct examination. That is the microscopy part where we generally prefer 10 to 40% of KOH. KOH stands for protection hydroxide. And इसके through हम initial जो diagnosis होते हैं उसको हम देखते हैं. जिसके through हमें ये सारी चीजें हमारे 40x में जब हम microscope में देखते हैं, low power में, then we can see this thing. And then after that, we release the primary report. Whether the fungal particles have been observed or not, fungal elements are present or not. And then we are also giving the a brief explanation about ki isme broad hyphae with the aseptic ribbon-like hyphae were seen. So it could be leukomycosis. Or usme then we are waiting for the confirmatory test where we are doing the culture method or the slide culture techniques. So in this fungal culture method, we can use a media. You all must be knowing that we are using SDA, that is saprolose, dextrose, agar with antibiotics to kill the that is bacteria. CMA stands for cornmeal agar and PDA stands for potato dextrose agar. Slide culture method is a very wonderful method. Even we are practicing in our lab, this slide culture method. This is actually the reason why we are using this slide culture method. क्या होते हैं कि जब हमारे पास samples आते हैं तो आइस के उसमें हमारे उसमें अल्टरनेरिया मिलने के चांसेस भी बहुत ज्यादा रहते हैं टू थ्री डेज बिफोर ओनली इन आवर लैब वी वर ऑब्जर्विंग वी रिसीव्ड अ सैंपल फ्रॉम अ पेशेंट ऑफ स्वैब आइस स्वैब उसका हमें मिला था एंड देन व्हेन वी वर डायग्नोसिंग व्हेन वी वर इन्वेस्टिगेटिंग दैट वी ऑब्जर्व दैट उसमें कुछ फंगल एलिमेंट्स तो हमें दिख रहे थे एंड दैट वॉज हैविंग अ टिपिकल फॉर्म ऑफ मैक्रोकोनिडिया जिसमें कंपार्टमेंट्स भी प्रेजेंट है एंड वी वर सो कंफ्यूज व्हाट टू गिव द रिपोर्ट अबाउट दिस देन लेटर ऑन वी ऑब्जर्व दैट कि इसमें ये भी हो सकते हैं कि ये इसके नॉर्मल कमेंसल्स भी हो सकते हैं नॉर्मल फ्लोरा भी हो सकते हैं सो इन ऑर्डर टू आइडेंटिफाई वेदर द थिंग इज प्रेजेंट और नॉट वी ऑल्सो परफॉर्म द कन्फर्मेटरी टेस्ट वेयर वी परफॉर्म द स्लाइड कल्चर टेस्ट स्लाइड कल्चर में क्या होता है कि फंगस का जो भी स्ट्रक्चर होता है वो इंटैक्ट रहता है वो ब्रेक नहीं होता I am sure you must have heard about the slide culture technique where we use a slide in a PDA, potato dextrose or cornmeal agar. We just inoculate the fungi of the sample in the four corners. We put a cover slip in a petri dish. We are providing the moisture environment in a tube. Then we place the slide. We incubate for it for a longer period of time, like you say for 24 hours or a day or overnight incubation. The next day we observe for the presence of इन फंगल एलिमेंट्स एंड देन हम उस पर स्टेन करके माइक्रोस्कोप पे देखते हैं उसमें कोई डिस्टर्बेंस नहीं होता है क्यों नहीं होता है क्योंकि हम उसकी टीजिंग नहीं करते हैं हम उसको डिस्टर्ब नहीं करते हैं टिश्यू आता है स्वैब आता है जो भी होता है उन सबकी टीजिंग होती है फ्लूइड आता है उसको कुछ ना कुछ हम यूज करते हैं सो नेकेड आई से जब हम कुछ परफॉर्म करते हैं हमें ये नहीं दिखता है कि हम इसके हल्का को तोड़ रहे हैं या फिर हम इसके इस पार्ट को तोड़ रहे हैं या फिर हम इसके इस पार्ट को तोड़ रहे हैं तो समटाइम्स क्या होता है माइक्रोस्कोप में सिर्फ ये सारी चीजें दिखती है कुछ नहीं दिखा सिर्फ ये दिखता है समटाइम्स क्या होता है कि सिर्फ हमें हाइटे दिख रहे हैं Sometimes क्या आपका हाइपे नहीं है कुछ नहीं ऐसे गोल गोल हमें स्पोरेंजियम्स दिख रहे हैं सो दैट इज वाई वी आर परफॉर्मिंग दिस स्लाइड कल्चर मेथड ऑल्सो यस इमेजिंग टेस्ट इज डन इन द रेडियोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट वेयर दे परफॉर्म द सीटी स्कैन एंड द एमआरआई जस्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड कि कितना ज्यादा इन्वेट किया है बोन्स को कितना ज्यादा डिस्ट्रॉय किया उसके बाद ये सर्जरी का जो होता है प्रोसीजर स्टार्ट होता है वेदर इट इज रिक्वायर्ड द सर्जरी और नॉट सो दैट इज कन्फर्म थ्रू सीटी स्कैन और एमआरआई विच इज मेनली डन इन दिस रेडियो डिपार्टमेंट Now, what is the current scenario of mucormycosis in India? Yes, so this is a report of 22nd May, which I found that is India reports about 8,848 mucormycosis cases. और जितने केसेस हो रहे हैं और उसमें ये है कि हमें एम्फोटेरिसिन बी का ही इसमें जनरली ड्रग्स दिया जा रहा है और इसमें कॉम्बिनेशन ड्रग्स दिया जा रहा है बट What happens sometimes it is we are observing that amphotericin se kisi patient ko effective nahi ho raha aur uske isme patient ki surgery ho rahi So as many as 28,252 cases of mucormycosis or the black fungus, it have been reported from 28 states, with a majority of them have been reported in Maharashtra, Gujarat. And then out of this 28,252 mucormycosis cases, they actually report that we actually need more supply of amphotericin B. जितना ये केसेस हो रहा है और जितना हमें ट्रीटमेंट की जरूरत है उसके लिए न्यूज क्लिपिंग्स वी हैव मेंशन दैट इज वी रिक्वायर मोर डोजेज ऑफ अ मोर अमाउंट ऑफ एम्फोटेरिसिन. एम्फोटेरिसिन बी इज अ ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर दिस एंड इट इज अ लिटिल एक्सपेंसिव बट स्टिल इट कैन बी अफोर्डेबल बाय द पेशेंट्स दोज हु आर इन्फेक्टेड. देयर इज अ मेजर ड्रॉबैक फंगस में यही होता है कि फंगस में जनरली एंटी फंगल ससेप्टिबिलिटी टेस्टिंग हम लोग नहीं करते. आई एम श्योर MIT स्टूडेंट्स कैन कोरिलेट दिस थिंग व्हाट इज द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ दिस. जब हमारे पास कोई भी बैक्टीरिया आते हैं कोई भी फंगस आते हैं हम उसका क्या करते हैं उसका हम एंटीबायोटिक या एंटी फंगल सेंसिटिविटी टेस्ट लगाते हैं. उसका मकसद क्या होता है वी नीड टू फाइंड इट आउट वेदर दिस पर्टिकुलर बैक्टीरिया इज सेंसिटिव टू दैट एंटीबायोटिक और नॉट और इट इज रेजिस्टेंट टू दैट एंटीबायोटिक. सो उससे फायदा क्या होता है कि ओनली दैट काइंड ऑफ ड्रग कैन बी प्रिस्क्राइब टू द पेशेंट. अगर हमें यही नहीं पता वो पेनिसिलिन का रेजिस्टेंट है या सेंसिटिव है तो उसको पेनिसिलिन देने का फायदा क्या होगा. अगर वो रेजिस्टेंट हुआ तो वी आर वेस्टिंग द टाइम एंड वी आर वेस्टिंग द मेडिकेशन ऑल्सो. So this is the major drawback in India. Here we do not perform this antifungal susceptibility testing because the procedure is a little complex. So drugs hote hain, it is a little expensive. So we do not get the drugs just for the performance of this antifungal susceptibility testing. So, but still we are using this amphotericin B for the main drug of choice. And also we are using the combination therapy. Now how to prevent this mucormycosis? The things which we need to remember is control hyperglycemia. We need to monitor the blood glucose level post COVID-19 discharge and also in the diabetics. We need to use the steroids very judiciously. If whatever the according to the 6 milligram is given as per the prescription. So whatever dose has been given, whatever the doctor has mentioned, how to take the drugs and in what duration, in what particular time, we actually have to maintain that. If we do not do that, then we are creating trouble to ourselves only, right? So it's the correct timing, the correct dose, and the duration is very, very important. We need use clean, sterile water for humidifiers during the oxygen therapy. This is again a very important factor. In many parts, it has been ignored. And the use of antibiotics or the antifungals judiciously. This is very, very important, though we do not pay much attention to this. But it is very important. It is very such factor which is responsible to cause a lot number of disease, a lot number of resistant strains. So that is the importance to use whatever antibiotics, whatever antifungals have been prescribed to us by the doctors, we need to take the proper course of the antibiotics or the antifungals. Without using that, hamara to ye theek ho gaya, 3 din mein hum usko band kar dete. This should not be like that. So that leads to the resistance problem. The don'ts which include, that is which the things which we do not, we should not do that. Do not miss the warning signs or symptoms. Suppose if you are having any of the symptoms, if you are having a mandible pain or if you are having a jaw pain, you are having lethargy problem, you are having a little irritation, you are having a discharge from your eye, or whatever things you are having, you should not ignore that. ये तो ऐसे ही हुआ होगा, ये वैसे ही हुआ होगा, नहीं ये pain तो ऐसे ही हो रहा है, ये तो मौसम अभी change हो रहा है, अभी गर्मी हो रही है. It should not be like that. Always be alert, but don't panic for any such thing. इसका मतलब ये भी नहीं कि कोई भी छोटे-मोटे pain के लिए आप panic करोगे. All are ready. What are the things which are actually troubling us? So which can actually lead to the problems. So if we are, that is why we have mentioned the symptoms also. In symptoms, we say, kuch bhi agar humko feel hota, we should not ignore that. Do not consider all the cases with blocked nose as cases of bacterial sinusitis. That is what I was saying. Ki har cheez ko ye mat sochna ki ye aise normal infection hua hai, ya phir it's because of the weather. It's not like that. Do not hesitate to seek aggressive investigations. जो भी investigation procedures होते हैं, KOH से अगर एक report निकलती है, microscope से, culture techniques होते हैं, MRD talk होते हैं, these are the techniques which we perform in our microbiology lab. So do not hesitate to seek all the investigation techniques जो भी आपको आपके investigation तक पहुंचे कि what exactly you are having or what is the disease you are having. Do not lose the crucial time to initiate the treatment for the mucormycosis. Yes, if you have been suspected to have this infection, go for the treatment as soon as possible without wasting time. So that is the only and most important thing is do not panic. The patients who are actually immunocompromised, the patients who have gone through corticosteroids treatment because of the COVID or some other reasons for arthritis or any heart disease or any other things, the patients who are having diabetes, the patients who are having AIDS, HIV infection or lymphoma or any other such immunosuppression therapy, or the patient who have gone to organ transplant, they are at majorly risk to acquire infections. All you have to do is be ready, be prepared, and protect yourself. Use all the basic precautions, being as a medical field or baakiyon ko bhi educate karo, what all the precautions or what all the basic measures which we need to follow in order to prevent ourselves from the COVID and the mucormycosis infections. So by ending this slide, an investment in the knowledge pays the best interest. So whatever knowledge we gain through attending the webinars or through attending any lecture session or through reading the news clippings, it actually use a lot for us. That is, it actually helps us to understand, to grasp the knowledge, which will pay for later time, for a betterment of life. That's about it. Thank you. Any doubt?
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
I'm Dr. Archana Jain from Paramedical Department for presenting vote of thanks to you for today's webinar. I would like to thank our guest, Ms. Suchandra ma'am, for enlightening us with the knowledge. Today's lecture was full of interesting knowledge about mucormycosis, how it is caused, what are the treatment, how you should prevent. Very nicely explained, beautifully explained with pictures. After seeing the picture, I was worrying so much. You know, it was, I can't see, you know, jisko hota hoga, wo bichare kitne mushkil se, pareshani se jhelte honge usko. Really thankful to you. And thanks to our, special thanks to our principal, sir, for providing the support to make the seminar successful. Our HOD ma'am, and without their support, we can't do this thing. Thank you so much. And thank you, our dear students, for attending and listening the seminar very nicely. Thank you so much. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you.